What's up, guys? This is HotIH7RCT bringing you another video, and in this case, guys, I bring you a 2-in-1. I'd rather treat these games with their own video, but considering the fact that basically this season is very, you know, full to the brim of games, I figured I had to at least showcase, you know, not exactly review, because of course, even though Skyrim is a very, very old game in terms of how long it's been in the market, and L.A. Noire, of course, is also a game that has been around for a while. These are games that, number one, either I haven't played in the longest time, or I just moved on from them from some point in time. So basically coming back to them now in the new platform and on the Nintendo Switch, we have to get around some of the settings and control schemes and stuff like that. So I'm not gonna be doing like a long play or anything like that. I'm just gonna showcase to you guys how well these games are running right now on the Nintendo Switch. These are games that are very welcome to the platform, and not only are they welcome, they are basically a shot in the air to third parties who are still doubtful of the potential of sales on the system. Now, I know I'm not the only one who's on board with having both of these games, even though, again, these are games that I have on Steam. These are games that I played just like Doom. However, there is a certain element of enjoyment that you cannot get on any other platform by playing it on the Switch. Now, I know a lot of people are going to be rolling their eyes at the thought of playing some 5 or 6 year old games just for the sole fact of it being portable, but it does hold some merit. I have to admit, it does hold some merit having to be able to play these in a portable way, you know, laptop notwithstanding, something simple, pick up and play, but yet it's a complete console quality title. And just like Doom, or I would say even more so than Doom, these are titles that did not have to go through a very long string of sacrifices in order to get it to the platform. On the contrary, both Skyrim and L.A. Noire, they come with some perks in the way of these being special editions of the original titles that came out for the 360 and PlayStation 3. So, yeah. That's basically the intent of my video today, because in the following weeks, I mean, I've already gone through the whole battery of games, including Star Wars Battlefront and the whole EA debacle, which is still ongoing, because I'm still basically at the point where I'm still playing the campaign. I'm kind of taking my time with it because I know it's kind of short, and since I'm not into the multiplayer aspect, it's going to take a while. And I want to see on the long run how well EA is going to deal with the backlash and the situation and the promised content that they promised to the people that was going to be free. We'll see. But that's another video. Let's go into L.A. Noire and Skyrim, which is what we came here for. So let me bring down the music here and then put it back on later, because we need to get our L.A. Noire on. So yeah, basically I took care of all of the downloaded stuff. I got another SD card for these third party titles that require a whole bunch of memory. As you can tell here, a quick look into the amount of software, you're gonna see that L.A. Noire alone is 13 gigs that you need to download in order to play the game, in order to run the game. So of course, I just, you know, I didn't think too much about it, and I grabbed a Samsung 128 gig, I believe is UHD 3, which runs up to 100 megabytes. And I also downloaded the multiplayer from Doom, and and the save files from Elder Scrolls, which is not too big. Now the rest of the space I'm gonna save for the other third parties. Let's say like if I grab NBA 2K, or if I want to get a Resident Evil Revelations, which is a huge download for the second one, I'll have more than enough space, and I still have my original SD card for the indies and all the other stuff that I want to keep. So yeah, and considering the price for a 128 gig, which will run you between 30 something and 40 something, I think it's pretty good. It's pretty manageable. So yeah, let's get out of here and let's go into, first let's set up, let me set up real quick here. Hold on a second, guys. Let me set up. Not set up exactly, just connect to the internet. Yeah, that's my connection. I named it No Noobs Allowed. Alright. Well, now we're cooking with gas. We are ready to rock and roll. Let's do this. Ah, seeing that R on the on a Nintendo platform, yeah, that feels pretty good. Let me actually go to the full screen here, and you guys can better appreciate what's going on. My ugly mug, of course, is going to cover some of the screen, so bear that in mind. Resume. Now, I can go from here to the social club, which I already set up and signed in and all that stuff. I was surprised to see this here because I didn't know that it was going to be a part of the Nintendo version. But it's good to see that the social club is set up, because that gives a little bit of hope that, you know, if they decide to bring over GTA, we might actually have the online aspect of it, you know, on the GTA Online and stuff. So that's pretty cool. I wish, I was hoping I could start a new game. There we go. Let's start a new game. Just so you can see the intro and all that nice stuff.
A city on the verge of greatness. A new type of city, based not on the man, but on the automobile, the car. A symbol of freedom and vitality. Where every man can own his own home, and have room to breathe, and not be overlooked by his neighbors.
Now, just so you know, guys, I basically re-downloaded my L.A. Noire version that I have on Steam. Just for comparison's sake. Oh man, it looks really good. This version looks really good compared to what we have come to expect from the original version and the remastered version.
The thoughts and desires of the entire planet. A city of pioneers.
Now this game, of course, became famous for what you're seeing right there in the cinematics, which is the incredible facial animation technology used back then. I mean, when you compare it to current-gen games, of course, maybe the graphics, they don't hold up as well, but that motion capture from the faces, the animations,
city that has no boundaries.
the little subtleness of everything going on, the facial expression, is still amazing to this day. And a very important tool, of course, given the way the gameplay is.
In the Marine Corps, you deal with the chain of command.
Where you need to basically, you know, take hints from watching the expressions of the criminals that you're, or potential criminals that you're going to be interviewing for the cases.
Or whether it's your partner, or maybe even the watch commander. So who do you trust, Cole? I made up my mind a long time ago.
KGPL calling car, 14 Adam. 14 Adam, come in.
Go ahead, KGPL.
14 Adam, see the detective and ambulance shooting at 6th and Industrial Street. Unit 16 William requests uniform assistance for an evidence search. 14 Adam, code 2.
Roger, 14 Adam en route.
And here we go, guys. They're giving control now.
Here we go again. They don't request uniforms for an evidence search unless there's some kind of catch.
Ever the optimist.
From the beam of sunshine himself.
Floyd Rose, homicide. You might back up?
Yes, sir. Phelps and Dunn, Wilshire Division.
We had a shooting took place down this alleyway. We have the Vic, Scooter Payton, a Negro male bagged up and on his way to Central Morgue. Witness says a tall white guy, our shooter, put two in the Vic's head and then threw his piece. I need you guys to try and recover the gat.
You want us to look anywhere in particular?
Give it your best shot, guys. The dead guy's a lowlife. I'm not expecting any miracles here.
And if we recover the weapon?
Bag it and return it to technical services.
You hurried up, Floyd. We
I'm
got places
here.
To be.
Happy hunting.
This is a fist hump. Just going through the motions.
And here we go, guys.
Let's just get it over and done.
All right, have it your way. We'll search right up to the back wall. If you still don't come up with anything, come find me and we'll talk it out. Two heads are always better than
good
one.
Here. Got your basic running.
Look at this junk.
Moving around. And you start investigating. I mean, you got your whole stuff. You know, you got your maps. Oh, wait. Got your maps. Map of the city. Little spirit of GTA there. Got your log. As things are happening in real time. Keep confusing the Xbox controls. The stats. And a whole slew of other things that you're going to be needing. Options and so on and so forth. And basically,
it's not my job to pick through other people's trash.
You're gonna feel like a little shake, a little rumble when you're next to a possible clue.
What have you got, Phelps? Anything?
And once you are there, you can pick up the object and start investigating. Look around.
I tell you, I'm jinxed.
And if it's not any good, just release it and keep going.
Cole, come take a look at this.
There's a newspaper here.
We're never gonna find it. It's a waste of time.
Choose the object you want to check and go for it. You can move it around. See if there's any details on it. But usually newspapers need to see. Go into a little cutscene so you can see what's going on with the backstory.
Dr. Fontaine. Could I have a word?
Of course, young man.
I really enjoyed your lecture, Doctor. Psychiatry seems to have a tremendous amount to offer.
Why, thank you. I'm always happy to receive acknowledgement for my work. The mind is the last great mystery in medicine. Are you thinking of specializing, Mr.
Sheldon, or Courtney Sheldon? I'm only in second year, Doctor. They fast-tracked me a year because of my experience during the war.
Ah.
That's what I wanted to talk to you about. Battle fatigue and collapse under duress. Can it be helped?
I would say yes.
So, yeah. That's at least what you will be seeing, at least from this piece of evidence or potential evidence. And to be honest, guys, this is the kind of game that you need to sit and just, like, get involved. Just, you know, look at everything in the environment. This is a very story-driven game. There's action involved, but the story is the star of the game here. So I know I haven't played much, but given that I just wanted to show you guys how well it runs, how responsive it is, and how everything looks, which, to be honest, it looks amazing. Here's another clue. As you start gathering clues and stuff, of course, the story keeps unraveling and unfolding until you get enough evidence to make your case.
Don't get all deep on me, Phelps.
So yeah, I'm gonna leave it here, guys. In case you want to pick it up, you should if you haven't played the game yet. Awesome title. There's a bit of a heavy download that is required in order for you to play the game. But I believe it's worth it, and I think it's the first step into getting more Rockstar games into the platform. So, yeah, pick it up if you can, because this might be it, guys. Maybe we'll be seeing in the future, not so distant future, Red Dead Revolver or GTA, who knows. But this game, at least in itself, is a pretty cool story that you should... You shouldn't leave out. You know, it's good for those moments where there's like empty spaces of lack of games coming out and stuff like that. It's good to just sit down, hunker down, and play through this very cool game from Rockstar. So let's go back here and exit the game. And now right here in real time, I will change the cart, which I have right here, for Skyrim. It's still incredible to me that the whole game of Skyrim is right here in that little cart. But yeah. Once everything is up and running, I will switch to the full screen. There we go. Always get a kick out of the music. Ah, all right, so Bad Luck is online, as I can see from the notification there. So loading, there we go. Here we go. Here comes the music. Yeah. I already have a file there. All right, enough of that. Let's start a new game. Beautiful, beautiful dragon right here. I love the shadowing and the texturing on some of the stuff here. Of course, it's already it's been established and proven that this game is leaning more towards a special edition that just came out for the PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. And nitpicking outlets place it between the last gen version, the original version, and the remastered one. But apparently it has a lot more assets from the remastered version than from the other one, so.
The border, right?
I wish there was a way to skip this. It would be nice, but
walked right into that Imperial ambush, same as us, and that thief over there.
Damn you, Stormcloaks. Skyrim was fine until you came along. Empire was nice and lazy. If they hadn't been looking for you, they'd have stolen that horse and been halfway to Hammerfell. You there, you and me, we shouldn't be here. It's these Stormcloaks the Empire wants.
We're all brothers and sisters in binds now, thief.
You know what? I'm not gonna go through this lengthy intro. I mean, this intro is basically everywhere. And especially on YouTube. I mean, it's a more than a 5-year-old game, so. I wonder. Yeah. That should get me where I left my save file, which is basically in the beginning of the game, but you don't have to wait here through the whole intro stuff. The intro serves more as a tutorial or to show you what goes on in the world of Skyrim, and yeah. Here, basically, I am making my escape from that cinematic, that cutscene. Eventually, I will get to this point where I'm trying to make my escape. Now, you have third-person view here. I love, absolutely love what they did with the shadowing and stuff. Ambient inclusion, the texturing, it looks beautiful. Little swing, and you got the magic on the other side, on the other hand. Everything is here, guys. I mean, everything. All the RPG elements that made Skyrim the time sinker that it is, because it is a time sinker. Destruction magic, which is what I have equipped right now, restoration, powers, and active effects. Amiibo. This is something that you didn't see in the 360 version, but since I don't have any amiibos, I'm not going to be able to do anything with that. But that's okay. Okay, so I came through this way, did I? Is there a weapon here I can pick? A mace. No, I don't want a mace. I have to get used to... This is the way I gotta get out. Okay. Gotta get used to using my regular first-person controls, which are inverted. But since I've been playing a lot of Battlefront, I've had to deal with changing that around. So I'm starting to get... I need to get used to using my old scheme again. It'll be a little confusing at first, but I'll get it down. Nice shadowing. Give me my gold. Gotta steal from the skeletons. Give me gold. I don't care if it's just one piece. Don't fucking hurry me. Or I'll burn your ass.
Better to stick together down here.
Ralph. Ralph, don't be an asshole, Ralph.
Orders are to wait until General Tullius arrives.
I'm not waiting to be killed by a dragon.
Whatever. Burn your ass. Ooh, arrows. Yeah, look at that. Already got a sword. And a longbow. Longbow, baby. Ooh, look at the nice water. I don't care if they're fighting. I want to see the water.
This goes.
Come on, let's do this. Fight, fight, fight. This is looking pretty good. Yeah, we'll find our way through here. Don't worry about it. Don't sweat it, dude. Ooh, look at the water. Nice water, fresh. And shiny.
I hope someone knows where we're going.
Oh, hell, it sure isn't me. Coin purse.
That doesn't go anywhere. Guess we'd better try this way.
Shut the fuck up, Ralph. Ooh, spider. Let's burn some fucking spiders. Ooh, baby. Yeah. Exact. It looks like the alien pods. Let's grab a spider egg. Why not? Make them nice and crisp. Anything up here? Nah, just some ice. Fuck it. Okay, so where did Ralph go? Was it this way? No, this is the way I came in. Ooh.
A bear.
I'd rather not tangle with her right now. Let's try to sneak by.
Fuck that. I want to kill it.
Watch where you step.
Or if you're feeling lucky, you can take this bow. Might take her by surprise.
Go ahead. I'll follow your lead and watch your back.
Should I shoot arrows at it? Let's try. Because if not, I got some magic. But the longbow is going to require both hands, which I don't like. Yep. But I can try the motion controls. Yay. So, I'm guessing that I draw. Yeah, I can use motion controls. Yeah. Shoot the fucking bear. I wanna shoot it in the head. I shot it in the ass. Oh shit. I think it's better. No skills. I think it's better if I think it's dead already. Okay, give me the Imperial Sword. And it's already dead. Look at that. Didn't even let me freaking burn you to crisp. I mean everything. I don't care. Kicking skeletons everywhere. Oh, here. This is a very good spot to check the lighting effects and stuff. That way you can check the textures. All that good stuff.
That looks like the way out.
So, believe it or not, guys, this is a pretty game. All things considered. Like I said before in the beginning of the video, this game and L.A. Noire, they didn't really need as many compromises as a game like Doom, which is very much more demanding current game. Excuse me. And here we are. We're outside in the wild. But this is where I'm gonna leave the gameplay for
there
now.
There he goes. Looks like he's gone for good this time. No way to know if anyone else made it out alive. But this place is going to be swarming with Imperials soon enough. Better clear out of here. My sister, Gerder, runs the mill in Riverwood, just up the road. I'm sure she'd help you out. It's probably best if we split up. Good luck. I wouldn't have made it without your help today.
So yeah, here we are. Out in the wild, ready to explore and take everything in. And this is precisely where I'm going to leave it. I'm going to do a quick save here. Another save. So yeah, guys. That has been Switch version of Skyrim and L.A. Noire. Let me bring it out of the game's music so I can start getting this here. So yeah, guys, that was L.A. Noire and Skyrim for Switch. I hope that what little you saw here from this video is good enough for you to go and pick them up if you're considering on getting the Switch or if you already have one. Bear in mind that you should, at the moment of purchase, have an SD card ready, because at least with L.A. Noire, there's a 13 gig required download before you even begin to play the game. So bear that in mind. That being said, I'm very happy with the purchase. I'm very happy with supporting these third parties, that these first, let's say the first wave of third party titles. And to be honest, for it being the first year, it's completely amazing what we've gotten so far. So I can't imagine what will come down the line in 2018 and beyond. So here's hoping for that and much, much more. So you guys, for the meantime, take care. This is Hot Diet 7 and RCT signing out. Check you guys later. Peace.